But there's something good about bad, because you have never made the decision to... God gave Adam... Adam is a figure in human history, which is a different kind of human being than the ones that were already existing. And so whatever they were, whether Neanderthal men, I don't know what they were, but suddenly this kind of human being appeared. We don't know where they came from. And they trumped over the Neanderthals and everything else. But they may have mixed and mingled, and sometimes you see very hairy people. Hold back is hairy, like one of my sons. He's got the body of a Neanderthal, but the soul of a saint.
So we mixed and matched at some point.
Somehow. Yeah. So, you could use him as a mat when he dies. You don't know.
Yeah. So, I've seen people like that. It should be illegal, but okay.
But see? But the thing is, these two appeared.
Adam,
not just one, two.
You are talking about Adam and Eve.
And so again, you have to have two to breed the same, right?
Right.
You can't have Eve, the first Eve, without an Adam.
Right.
So you had to have two.
Right.
And it wasn't the evolution starting all over again from some cell.
Right.
Right. So
it's a different kind of person.
But he gives the man the choice: love God or play God. And the tree of life was, and the tree of good and evil was simply the place where he has the choice. Remember, God cannot make love. Now, we use the word making love when having sex. I mean, it's not making love anything. It's screwing up your life.
Right.
So not always.
Becoming more of an animal.
Yeah, becoming more of an animal and replacing your dying, stupid self.
Right. And feeling good about your animal body instead of realizing it's the vessel for
and
your
the more
soul.
And the more you're reassured that you were something having sex, then you've conquered something and you really... Right. You know, you had a good lay last night. And
bigger
you're,
animal.
You're a bigger animal.
Less soul, less spirit.
And the hungrier you put, the less you are, the hungry, more sexual you are, because you have to replace your dying self.
Right.
And so you die and do it and do it and do it till it kills you.
Right. And then you become addicted.
Pornography kills you. Yes. Pornography is one of the biggest causes of murder and suffering.
Yeah, it's terrific. It's horrific.
So I had one man said to me in England when I was there, he says, I got so bad. He says, if a woman would knock on the door, I'd be on the floor with her. And it'd be like every day, indifferent. And so he said, and then I get angry and blame her for my conflict. And the more I got angry, the more sexual I became. The more sexual I became, the more I had sex. The more I blamed the woman for whatever I didn't know what was happening to me, because I was becoming less of a person. Until the lust and the hate... The love and the hate came closer and closer together until I found myself strangling her while I was having sex with her. See how that is?
Yeah, I do.
Now you understand it, you see?
And then what about the woman who isn't supplying that to the husband? He resents, my husband resented me horribly, horrifically.
Well, you're resentable.
Yeah, but he also resented me when I was...
Yeah, but the point is, men always blame women for their fault in dealing with them. And they don't understand what their fault is. They don't understand. They come from a lineage of a fallen man. See, the lineage is that.
Right.
So they're born subject to the women, and the evil of the world ensconced in politics. In other words, politics is evil. If we listen to our conscience, said Thomas Jefferson, we would need no other lawgiver. Do you think politics wants that? Politics doesn't want you to.
They wouldn't have a job.
They wouldn't have a job. We'd have smaller government just to build the roads.
If people were self-directed for good.
That's right. But they make sure that doesn't happen.
Right.
The schools made sure it didn't happen.
Like
didn't,
the doctors
didn't you see
have
it?
To keep using their
But
system.
Didn't you see it? Didn't you see that the schools made sure it didn't happen? They invented. And so they confused and convoluted the minds. It turned our common sense on its head, confused the kids, and then made up a disease, bipolar, and then gave them Ritalin and Prozac. And so that's what they have. In the early days, there's a certain doctor that invented a disease, and he gave it a name, and I can't remember the name, for slaves that want to run away. They called it a disease, so that gave the owners the right to beat them up to cure them, just like fathers beat their children up to make them mind.
Right. Right.
They gave it a disease and gave an excuse. So the same thing is with all the different illnesses. all the different psychiatric problems that people have, which don't exist. There's now 300 different diseases they treat, and none of them are diseases. They're all problems related to what we've been talking about
the resentment
this morning. Now, but the goodness of it, to make it nice and clean, is that you have never made it. You have never made a choice to do evil. You were born subject to it, so you couldn't help yourself. And then you blame yourself. And then you get entangled, and God's watching, and he's following you like the hound of heaven with something called conscience. But it makes you think the conscience is the enemy. And so therefore your misery and suffering is complicated, and you're completely lost. And then rise all the gatekeepers, the rabbis, the priests, the imam, the psychiatrists. All the teachers, and see,
everyone's going to cure you.
So all the worst people get in power because the best people are confounded.
Then they're judging.
And see, and so, but the point is, and then we have revolutions, and then it starts all over again. In Mexico has had 5 revolutions, and it always end up being just as the savior that comes along is worse than the dictator they've toppled, right? So America is a very unusual place. Nothing like it. Nothing. Maybe early Rome, which was a republic that lasted 800 years, 400 years of beauty and majesty, and 400 years of horror in the decline.
That's what's happening to us.
That's what's happening to us, you see, because the bats are getting in the belfry. We are, the ordinary person is sweet and gentle, like Apocalypto. Remember that movie, Apocalypto, where you have a tribe of people living in Brazil or South America or Mexico, forget where the scene was, and they were happy. They didn't know what was happening to the outside world. They were oblivious to it.
Right.
Good people just want to be happy.
Right.
But they just, and their happiness is okay. Trouble is, it's naive. But there's a little pocket of naivete, and they had to suffer. I mean, to have their hearts cut out and roll down the pyramids. Right. They couldn't understand what they were getting into. America was a good country. Not that there wasn't bad, but we would try to root it out, try to get rid of racism and all the rest of it. And so you haven't got rid of it because now you've got reverse racism. You've got the, you see? Yeah, in Africa, I left Africa, which was the tyranny of the minority supplanted by the tyranny of the majority, which is worse, you see?
Because that ego has to have something to hate.
See, so this has to have something. It has no life of its own. It has to take the life away from others and take pleasure in it. It literally takes your life, and if you give into it, you empower it. So liberals in this country are really decent people, but they don't want to. But they don't want to become like their mothers and fathers, or they've been spoiled by their mothers and fathers, and they're living in la la land. So they attract that weakness attracts evil from far off, or close by. So, but they don't. But then they find themselves in a quandary. They don't want to be like their parents. So they tend to overlook it so they don't have to be angry. And that encourages the problem. And eventually they have to give their sons and daughters to fight the enemy, which can no longer be avoided because during the years they've simply made it happen. Put it off for the future what should have been done today. All because of this stuff inside their head that makes us weak in our goodness. See that?
Mm-hmm.
You need to be strong in goodness. So now I'm coming to the good part of it. So this has been like a little grand finale, because I think I've answered most of your questions, haven't I? So you have never made a decision because you were born in sin. The Bible absolutely is accurate. We are born into a sinful world. Your parents preceded you. I didn't know. My wife, I didn't know. I was naive, but I was very intuitive. I have had very little trouble in my young life. No matter what happened, I seem to be floated down the Nile in a reed basket and somehow got past what the Israelites suffered. So I had the ability to see what they didn't see, and I was unflappable. I didn't know I was unflappable. I thought everybody else was like me. And because I never was bothered by anybody saying said to me, I just could just did what, and it didn't notice it. Only when I got married did I get resentful and notice I was becoming sensitive to things. But then I had a background in hypnosis because I had been in the army and done lots of it and was very acquainted with how mind works. And I saw it happening to me.